The topic is identifying explanatory and response variables. So let's talk about what we're looking for here. We're trying to study a relationship or an association between two variables of the same individual. Let's read the definition first of all. The definition says the response variable is what we hope to predict or explains. The explanatory variable is the predictor variable or what explains. So we're always interested in the response variable. That's what we're trying to learn about. And the X, so the response always go to the Y value. So response variable is the Y value. And X is the explanatory variable. Okay, what else? We also say there's an association between those variables, X and Y, if they both vary together. Definition is right here. If they vary together means if X increases, Y increases, or if X increases, Y decreases. That's what we mean with they vary together. So let's read the question. Suppose you were to collect data for each pair of variables. You want to make scatter plot. Which variable would you choose on the explanatory variable and which as the response variable? What would you expect to see in the scatter plot? Discuss the likely directions, form, and strength. So let's do number A. A says number of miles you drove since filling up and the gallons remaining in your tank. So we're more interested on the number of gallons remaining in your tank. So that would be the response. Response will be gallons remaining in the tank. And the explanatory, what explains that, is the number of miles driven. So number of miles driven. And of course, since we're using the same car, the association will be, we start with the direction, it will be negative. Why? Because as the number of miles goes up, as the number of miles goes up, the gallons remaining in the tank goes down. So it's negative. So the association is negative. The form is linear. And the strength will be strong. Actually very strong because we're using the same car. Very strong. Alright, let's move on to the next one. The price of a t-shirt at a store and the number sold. Again, we're interested on the number of t-shirts sold. So number of t-shirts sold will be the response. And the explanatory is the price. So also as the price goes up, the number of t-shirts sold goes down. Right? Number of shirts sold goes down. So it's negative. So negative was linear and it's strong. Okay, what else? The shoe size for C, now we're doing C for the shoe size of college students and their grade point average. Of course, the shoe size, there is no association. So here, they cannot talk about explanatory response. no association between these two variables. The amount of time spent studying for an exam and the grade on the exam. So we're interested to know more about the grade. So grade of exam. So explanatory will be the amount of time studying. Amount of time studying for the exam. So as the amount of time studying for the exam goes up, most likely the grade of the exam will go up. So it's positive. As x goes up, y goes up. As x goes up, y goes up means positive. So the association is positive. What about the form? Of course, it's linear and it's strong. However, we will have some outliers. Outliers means there will be some people that will study, that will spend a lot of time, but they will still do bad. They still have bad grades. And we will have some people that will study less time, not too much time, and will still have good grades. Now for E, the crop yield and the amount of yearly rainfall. Of course, we're interested on the crop yield, so that would be the response. And the explanatory will be amount of rainfall. Number of rainfall. So the association as rainfall, right, as the number, as the amount of yearly fall goes up, we have the crop yield goes up. So the association is positive, straight or linear, and strong. The height of a husband and the height of wife, no association. And last one, the weight of apples in grams and the weight of the apples in ounces. Here it doesn't matter, either one could be explanatory, either one, and either one could be the response. But here the association, of course, it's positive. This is so obvious. Not only positive, linear and very strong. Actually, it is so strong that it's gonna fall on the same line. All the points will fall on the same line. And that's it for this example.